गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई ब्रॉट यू अ वीडियो रिगार्डिंग द कनेक्शन ऑफ अ डेटाबेस यूजिंग XAMPP सर्वर. ओके, व्हाट वी विल डू इज वी विल क्रिएट अ HTML फॉर्म, रजिस्टर फॉर्म, एंड देन वी विल यूज द PHP माय एडमिन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव टूल फॉर माय SQL डेटाबेस टू क्रिएट द डेटाबेस एंड टेबल्स, एंड विल कनेक्शन सेट अप द कनेक्शन टू लोकल होस्ट बाय यूजिंग द XAMPP सर्वर. ओके, सो we'll start the video. Before starting the video, I will say you that please subscribe my channel for more programming related videos that I used to upload. If you are new to this channel, okay, and if you like the video, then like it. If you found it informative, you can share it to other ones, okay. And okay, fine, we will start with the video. Let's start with the HTML registration form. Okay, we will create a HTML form. Okay, HTML okay, let's start this, and sample tutorial for database connection. Okay, I will take as this. Then in body section I will take the form. Okay, form again action attribute is there always. Okay, I will first set it blank, then the method as this. Okay, then the form is closed. Okay, I am closing the form. Now I need the register form details like name, first name, last name. Okay, so I will, but for that I should create a table for that. Okay, because in a tabular format, if I do that, then it will look better. Okay, table, then I will give the table a border, so it look me. Okay, border is equal to 1. Okay, so now I will take now the tr tag. Okay, so it will take the row. Okay, in that I will take a label. Okay, and label to be displayed as enter the first name, like that, or I will say only enter first name. Okay, and I will close it. Then in the row section again I will take a input box. Okay, input type is equal to text, name is equal to first name. Okay, I will take this as the first name, and it will display a blank text over there. Okay, so what I will do is I have not taken the td tag. Okay, I have not used this. In this, actually what I will do is in td I will complete this. Okay, again I will take td tag, and within this I will, is because inside the td only the tag should be the, okay, see over here, like this I have completed the first field. Okay, and I have, see over here, I have saved it in desktop. Okay, as, see over here, as sample register. Okay, sample register dot html. Okay, so now I will again I have completed this, and then I will again, I will, what I will do, I will do the copy paste part. Okay, okay, till I do the correction, I will pause the video. Okay, till I do all the typing work over here, I will pause the video. Okay, save or submit, and the value to be there as appear on it as save or submit. Okay, done. Now this code is done. Okay, we'll see the part. Okay, see over here, and I will make this background color some from take the use of color picker, and from there I will take use of this color. This okay, or this I take okay, fine. I have taken this color and I will paste it over here and I will check. Okay, now it looks like this. Now it looks like some nice. Okay, see over here why it is showing like this, because I have not taken out this, because only I need is. Again, make this constant as 2 and align it at center. Okay, center it aligned, and I will. Okay guys, I have done with the HTML form coding section. Okay, I have done with this, and see over here, I have taken the HTML title tag to appear the title window in the title web browser. Okay, this thing, and then body, the background color, I have mentioned it over here. See over here, I will show you the output. See how it look like, the background color, it is came from here. And the head in title section, see over here, it is showing in the title section. Okay, the as simple tutorial base connection. Okay, database connection, like then details entry it in header tag. I have taken this, then I have taken the form. Okay, action, still I have not specified the action method, that is action file. Okay, so I will take over here and see over here, I have mentioned all the details, that table, and you the first name, then the last name, then the gender, then the email, then the phone. Okay, all I have taken, and I have taken the submit. Okay, you can pause the video. Okay, I am giving you, or you can take the code from the in the link description below. Okay, so you can take out from there also. Okay, now I will proceed for the database connection part. Okay, so for that, firstly we have to check it our database server is there or not, on or not. So for that we have to check it XAMPP server. We have to start this. Okay, regarding this, if you have any issues in connection or installation and all that, I will provide the video in the i-link button over upsides of my video. Okay, you can check it out from there. Okay, so if you have any doubts in the connection section, if you come across some error, then you please comment me, then I will help you out definitely. So see over here, I've started this boot. Now I will check in this that my localhost connection is on or not. Okay, see over here, that means my connection is present now, it is on, because these are all started, so I am able to start this localhost operations. Okay, now what I will do is I will create a database inside this. Okay, database, you can say db or database 1 2 3. Okay, I will create like this, database 1 2 3. Okay, inside this I have to now create a table. Okay, so I will create a table name entry details. Okay, and I have, I guess, how much fields I have, 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, I have 5 fields, so I will take as 5. Okay, now I will create this database parts. Okay, first I will take this first name I have in this, so actually I am because it will, the video will be elongated than else, so I am taking the things in the cache only, cache memories that it stored. Okay, first name, last name, and what else it is, then gender, email. Okay, then gender, okay, gender is also in varchar, this is also in varchar, okay, the character, then gender, then email, okay, that is also in varchar, okay, then after, what else, mobile, I guess, okay, so I will take mobile or contact some else, okay, so, okay, I will take this as begint, okay, and 10, okay, so now I will save it and see over here. The database has created, been created with these 5 fields: first name, last name, gender, email, and mobile. Okay, now we'll start with the database file, PHP file, for retrieving all data. Now we will create a PHP file that will deal with the database insertion operations. Okay, that to insert the data into the database, we will write a PHP file, because this is a PHP MyAdmin administrator tool for MySQL database operations. So we will write a PHP file that will fetch up with this HTML file. Okay, so we'll start writing that file. We'll go to the new and we'll start writing. Username as root, as you all know, it is now the password. Okay, it is blank because I have not set the password. Now the database name. Okay, what is the database name is? We'll see over here. It is database 123. Database 123. Okay. For the safety purpose, I will save this file, okay, as PHP, and remember this thing, it is compulsory to save it in C folder under that XAMPP under htdocs, because the local host, it is connected to this file folders, so we have to always place write the code anywhere else and place it here, or else directly save it here, okay, and I will make it as details entry.php file. Only compulsorily PHP file will be needed, okay, for this files. Okay, it came. Now I will go further. Okay, pause the video and write the code. Okay, done. Let I explain you all these things. Okay, see over here, I have written server name as localhost, username as root, by default it is, then password, it is blank because I have not set over here by going to the privileges sections and all that. I have not gone to there and change the password. Now the connection with MySQLi connect function will have 4 parameters. Okay, the server name it will take, the username, okay, for which it will be connecting, and the password for that database name. Okay, now it will check if the connection is not proper or connection is not done through this. Okay, so it will show an error. Okay, that my connect error. I will show you over here that when we gone to here. Okay, I will go over here. See this connection. Okay, so then it will check the it will take the save of this, okay, that I have mentioned over here. See this name of submit button. Okay, then it will snatch that parameter, then it will take all the parameters of this form. See over here, first name, last name, then this gender, email, all will fetch from this, okay, in post parameter. Okay, as we are using the post method over here also. See over here, we have used the post method. Okay, then I can tell you that difference between post and get is what, simple, when in this the address bar you will see the in the get method, you will see all the data that you are entering, okay, in your text boxes over here. That means the security is not there in that, but in post method it will not show any data in over that address. Okay, so now I will save it in the variables. Okay, I have saved this variables, these fields to these variables, and then I have fired the insert query. Okay, insert into entry details. Okay, let's see what the database table name is. The table name is entry details, so I have taken entry details. Then the column names. Okay, see our first name of this columns, see over, is it right? First name with space, last name. Okay, first name, last name, gender, then email and mobile. This all I have taken. Then the values are this that is coming from here. Okay, I will show you in this. See over here, guys, for the this file of the Excel, the HTML file that we have designed, we have to go for that through localhost. Okay, only localhost. Because in the localhost in htdocs we have saved, actually in that time also I've told in previous time. See over here, sample register. Okay, we'll do like this, backslash and sample register. Okay, then the form will come. Okay, here the form is there. Okay, see over here, the first name, last name, the genders, the email, the phone, and then submit. So we'll check over here. See, okay, the first name, last name, gender, email and phone, all I have done. Then it will check the whether the connection and the query is proper, the column names and the proper match, okay, with the this tables. Okay, then it will go as it will give the successful message as new data entered, else the error. Okay, then the connection will close over here. Okay, you can take the code from by pausing the video, or I will provide you in the description box the link. Okay, so we'll move further. Okay, we'll run this thing. Okay, so what I will do is I will run this. Okay, Ajankya Rane. Okay, then we'll use Ajankya only. Then we will use some surname as this, then the mail. Then we'll check for this that whether it is validated or not. Okay, see over here, when I submit this, it shows this error because we have validated this by taking direct, you have direct facility as you have taken type is equal to email like this. Okay, so Ajankya dot das at the rate gmail.com. okay, and the phone numbers. Okay, I have taken this phone numbers. I will submit. Okay, see over here, it is not submitted. Okay, why? We will check it out. Means the screen not came like new registered. I guess it is not processed in the server side only. Okay, so we'll check what happened with the codes. Over here we have taken submit, save. Okay, and over here we have taken as save. Okay, we will check with the files by opening in Notepad. You can open it simple. We'll check for that button. Okay, it is submit and save. Okay, name is save, and the file name, it is saved or what? See over here, the file name, it is not saved over here. Means the action file, so it is not came. Okay, we'll go over here. Okay, we will see over here, we have not written. Okay, so it is not came, means so the it not processed only the by firing the submit button. So we have to write as details entry dot php. Okay, I've taken over here, I will now run it. Okay, again all the details we will fill it loud nice. Ajankya Das, I guess. Okay, then mail, then email as Ajankya Das. Okay, and the phone number as like this. Okay, now we will submit. Then also it not came, I guess it not saved actually. We will save, make it, save it as save as okay, sample register. Alright, now we will check this thing. Then kya? Das, then mail, then das, then the number. See over here. Now it came. Okay. Now see what it shows. That server name in this on line 7. Okay, we'll check the what the error is for server name on line 7 in details entry. Okay, see over here. This is the thing. Okay. See the server name, it is not matching like this. Okay, see what I have done is I have taken over here server name like this, and over here I have taken as it is like this. Okay, so I have to use the same variable that we have called. Now I will submit. See over here, now it shows as new details entry inserted successfully. We'll check it out over here, whether it inserted or not. Over here, the first name, the last name, then this gender, this all things at same. We will again go to the localhost sample register, then save our lady's data. So the female option is saving or not, we will see that also. So gmail.com, then the phone number, again it inserted successfully. We will check it out over here. See, Sushma Das and the female and this email ID. Okay, see, we have done with this tutorial, this video. I have completed that how to connect, how to create a form, HTML form, and that after connecting that in the HTML form, how we will use the XAMPP server. Okay, establish the connection to the XAMPP server with this local host. Okay, then we have created the database and the table in the phpMyAdmin. Okay, then we have tried to insert the data in the database through a PHP file. Okay, that details entry PHP file. Okay, we have connected with this, and then successfully we entered the details, okay, in these forms. Okay, then we have successfully registered the datas, and we have checked it out. Okay, so the video is today is regarding the how to connect with a database using XAMPP server. Okay, that forms we are filling the data from the forms and connecting to the database using XAMPP server. Okay, with the help of phpMyAdmin administrator tools for MySQL database operations. Okay, so till then, I'll tell you that please subscribe my channel for updated videos, the latest videos, okay, regarding to programming, okay, and physics subjects. Okay, so if you like my video, you like it, if you find it informative, then you share it. Okay, and if you have any comments, please comment in the comment section. Okay, till then, thank you, have a good day.